All right, first and foremost, last time I saw you, I asked if this fight was possibly going to be able to get happen, and now you were right, the fight did get happen. So yeah. What's your thoughts on just this whole entire experience?
I'm just excited that the fight is finally happened, the fight's made. I'm excited for March 29th, and you know, like we said, it's been some years in the making of trying to make it happen, and I'm glad that it actually didn't happen previously, and it's happening now, because this is the perfect time to be boxing, as we were saying during the presser.
You feel like, you know, he came over to you, Oscar, and shook hands to bury the hatchet. But do you feel like until fight night, you have all belts strapped around you, that's officially everything's done, and officially you can kind of go amends in your career?
I mean, it'll always be personal for me, you know, reasons that many people won't understand. But, you know, I'm glad we hashed out a little bit on stage, because I don't want to badmouth Oscar Golden Boy Promotions during this whole lead up to the fight. It's about me and Yokosuka getting in the ring and facing each other. So when I walk out of the ring as undisputed champion, that'll say everything.
Sarissa, do you believe that the Mexican audience is going to be with you?
Oh, yeah. Glendale, Arizona is definitely going to show up. They have a great fan base there of Mexican fans, so I'm excited for them to show up for me.
How's it feeling to have a Mexican blood in your veins?
Oh, feels great. We're gonna see that Mexican blood come out on March 29th for sure.
Sunisa, I talked to you about all the times other fighters have been wanting to fight you. Does it kind of make you feel like, oh, I'm that bitch? Like, everybody's calling my name.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I know that I knew that as long as my team steers my career in the right way, that I would be the money fight for all these women in the lower divisions, which is great. I'm happy that I can be that, so that way we can bring some eyes on the lower weight divisions, because we have Amanda Serrano and Katie Taylor with the higher weight classes, but there's never been anybody like myself to be able to bring that exposure to the lower weight classes.
So. Sunisa, you said that you fight
I do, yeah, definitely. I do. I mean, I moved up to weight classes to fight Marlon Esparza, who is an Olympian and a very good fighter. And in my opinion, I think Esparza would definitely be biased. So that just shows that, you know, I have been in there with better fighters, but I'm still not taking her lightly. I know she's going to come in and be in shape like she always is, and she's aggressive and throws a lot of punches. So I expect her to come out and try to give it all she's got. But I'm extremely prepared. I feel like as long as I listen to my trainer and I train hard and do what I'm supposed to do, it's there for me. It's there for me to walk out of the ring as the champion.
Oscar showed you respect and love. What is your opinion? I believe it was a great moment.
Yeah, it was definitely. That was our first time interacting face to face since I've been signed with Golden Boy Promotions. So, like I said, I don't. It's still personal for me, but I don't want there to be any animosity leading up to the fight with me and Oscar and Golden Boy Promotions. When I get in the ring on March 29th, I'll do the talking for everything.
Any message to the Costa Rica fans who maybe might, you know, not have a side yet, or any message to them? You know, you say you don't want to be animosity, how about the fans? Like, any message to the Costa Rican fans?
To the Costa Rican fans? I mean, tune in on March 29th, and my message is to all the American fans and all the Mexican fans out there. This one's for you guys. This one's for all my fans.
Was there anything different from the last face-off you did in the ring to this face-off? Any difference in energy, or just the same old, you know, energy that you had last time?
Same, yeah, but it's very, very intense, because I want this so badly. I want to become undisputed, and I'm so competitive, so I don't want to be friends with her. I don't want to be friendly. Like, this is competition, and I'm extremely competitive, so I'm going to stay that way until after the fight. And then if I still like being friendly after the fight, maybe I will, maybe not.
You know, since you're entering the undisputed realm, you know, Clarissa's undisputed, Alicia's undisputed, you're thinking about maybe making like a mega fight down the just what's your thoughts on something like that, seeing the fact that you might join that class of undisputed female fighters?
And facing who?
Alicia and Clarissa. Just
being in the so right now in the ESPN pound for pound, I'm number 5, and my goal is to definitely rise up and show that I can possibly be number 1 pound for pound. I mean, Clarissa's held that spot for a long time, as she deserves to. So does Amanda Serrano, so does Katie Taylor. Like, we're all doing such great things in women's boxing that we all deserve to have that spot, and everyone is going to be undisputed at the same time. But you know, my thought has never been pound for pound, you know, because everybody has their own opinions. I just want to become undisputed, and not at just one weight class, but at multiple weight classes. And you know, people can rate me on their list wherever they want, but as long as I know that I'm undisputed in multiple divisions, then that's what I really want.
Where can we cop that shirt? Let the fans know where they can get that shirt.
You can get this shirt at www.superbadboxing.com. Go get it right now.
Cisa, you've been using your physical strength in a lot of your recent fights to walk a lot of the ladies down. Mm-hmm. Based on Yocasta's last fight against Ortiz, do you think she can handle that type of style from here?
I mean, I don't want to say too much of my game plan, but I mean, I know that she can only fight one way, and that's coming forward. That's being aggressive. That's throwing a lot of punches. And I hope she throws a lot of punches. I love it. I love when fighters throw a lot. Like, every one of my opponents throws, they throw a lot of punches at me because they know that I'm here, I'm there, I'm left-handed, I'm right-handed. So they are throwing punches anywhere they can. And I know her mentality going into this fight is trying to throw a lot of punches to overwhelm me, but I like that. Let her try to overwhelm me, and I'm gonna use my defense and my footwork to make her look silly.
She does grapple a lot. Any worries about headbutts or anything like that?
She does like to hold on the inside, and that's because she doesn't really like to. She doesn't really know how to fight on the inside. So that's something that I'm definitely working on and keeping in my mind and in the game plan as well, is not let her tie me up like she likes to, because she feels safe in that position.
You initially criticized her performance with someone that you beat very decisively. What did you take away from watching that performance with her against Annabelle?
You know, I knew Annabelle would do exactly what she did. And she made it a rough fight on the inside. And Annabelle Ortiz is that type of fighter. That's why my game plan going into the fight was to make it look as clear and crisp as possible. And I don't think no one's ever beat Annabelle in that way, but that's all because of my footwork, my defense, and being able to stay smart and stick to the game plan throughout the whole fight. And I know, Viola's not really capable of that. So, it was a rough fight between them.